Surgery in itself is scary. When I was training, pretty much all the surgery we did was through big incisions. Even if you had to deal with a small area in the body, you still had to make a pretty big incision to get there. Right away, I realized there's got to be a better way.
To do an open surgery, you have to stick in your hand. With a single port, you don't have to disturb all that tissue because you are going right to the source.
Single port is a robotic platform that enables surgery through a single incision or natural orifice.
It's allowing us to do surgeries differently than we did with the multi-port. That's the key to this.
By providing the ability to access anatomy in different ways, we're really setting up the potential for improved outcomes.
What every patient wants, they want to get back to their life. Single port robotics is allowing us to get them to that point, and that is really exciting.
Okay, you're good to go?
Yeah.
Okay. The really exciting thing about da Vinci single port is that we're providing surgeons with another tool in their toolbox. Traditionally, surgery is performed by accessing the anatomy through multiple incisions. Single port enables that same type of procedure through a single incision.
The unique capability is that once in the body, the instruments and the endoscopes can articulate. So you see, you've got triangulation at the camera and you've got triangulation at the elbow joint in addition to the wristed articulation.
When we launched SP in 2018, what we found was that our early adopters of the technology started using SP's unique capability to innovate the surgical approach.
As an early adopter, you have significant responsibility to the patient, to the public, and to your fellow surgeons to look at this very critically. And I knew in our department, we had those people, like Dr. Mutahar Ahmed, who were going to figure this out.
When a new technology comes out, if your mind is open to it, you can always learn something new and do it better, perhaps. And why not take advantage of that?
The whole idea behind robotics is sort of like miniaturizing your hands and putting them into the body. What single port does is it's further enhancing our ability to minimize trauma to the patient, but it's also allowing us to do surgeries we just couldn't do using the other platform.
So initially when we were using the SP, we were just trying to copy what we were doing in multiport. But then as we got used to it, can I do something differently to get to where I want to go? That flexibility of thinking is very important if you really want to be an innovator. Always think, how can I make it a little better?
Okay, good. That's it. Now just take these adhesions down and you're done.
We saw a patient and he had an aggressive prostate cancer, multiple abdominal surgeries done, and he went to a lot of surgeons and was told, no, we can't do it this way. You have too many adhesions, you have too many abdominal surgeries, and it's too risky.
Because of my previous surgery, he wouldn't be able to do it. So he says, I need to do what's called a single port entry. I said, what the heck is that? He says, oh, there are only a few people who do it. That's how I got Dr. Stifelman.
And he came to us and we were able to offer that to him.
He said, lift up your shirt, show him the previous surgery. And even from there, he was saying, yeah, I can do it.
We can directly go into the bladder through just a small incision in their belly button versus going into the abdomen. We can do very complex procedures that we're just gonna do before. And so he's just one of many examples of how we're able to help a lot of patients not only do it less invasively, but even some patients who weren't able to be offered this prior.
Take care, guys.
One question I hear is, why do SP? Is it really better? And I think it's remembering the lessons from the initial robotic platform we had and seeing how that transformed what we did, and that through perseverance, through collaboration with colleagues, through sharing ideas, we really overcame that.
My perspective is we never stop innovating. We're at the beginning of this journey and there is a lot of possibility that the future holds for us.
We all have realized that adopting this technology has made us better surgeons and is allowing us to train the next generation of surgeons more effectively.
Yeah, it requires a little bit of learning curve, but when you see, forget about 10, 20, one patient after 2 years is able to urinate normally, and this patient may say, "Doc, thanks for giving me my life back." That's the key. That's the energy that you get to do the next tough case.